Learn how to run app servers on Arc-enabled Kubernetes in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. In this second of three videos, we'll use an Azure Arc-enabled server, which is an on-premises computer, to run a Kubernetes cluster and connect that to Azure Arc. Before you can do that, your Arc-enabled machine needs to adhere to the following requirements. My machine has everything that is needed and is running a local Kubernetes cluster. Here we are. This is my local machine that is already onboarded to Azure Arc. And in this command line, I'll first log in to Azure, like this. This opens a browser. And once I've logged in, it is done. OK. Next, I'll create a resource group with this command. OK, that's it. Let's clear this up. And now I use this command to connect my local Kubernetes to Azure Arc with the resource group. There it goes. And that's it. Let's take a look in the Azure portal. This is the Azure Arc overview, and here are the connected Kubernetes clusters. There it is. Cool! I can now manage the cluster from Azure. I have lots of options like setting policies for the cluster, configuring GitHubs, and also monitoring. Let's see. I can see the performance of the cluster, and I can also look at its nodes and drill down into them. Very cool. All right, let's do something special. I'll go to Extensions and add one here. I can use the Kubernetes cluster that runs on my local machine as compute to run other services like API management or an app service web app or function. Let's do that. I'll add the app service extension. Here goes. Let's see. First, I'll give the extension a name, like this. And I don't need autoscaling, but you can use that. And here I need to create a new custom location. This is a virtual construct that users use to deploy things to. Okay. Next, I need to add a publicly available IP address. This should be the public address of your local Kubernetes cluster. Okay. Next. I'll leave monitoring disabled. And next. This looks fine. Next. And this is the script that I need. I'll copy it and switch to my local machine. Here it is, and this is an elevated PowerShell prompt. Now I just paste the script. This prompts me to log into Azure. That's it. This will take a while, so I'll skip to when it is done. All right, now for the next bit. I'll create a web app in the app service instance. First, some parameters to make things easy. And I'll get the ID of the custom location that we've created earlier. And now to create the app service plan. This is just like creating a normal app service plan, only in a custom location. That is all that is needed to deploy to the Arc-enabled Kubernetes app service. Okay, let's clear this. And now for the web app itself. There it goes. And I'll skip ahead. Now that I have a web app, I'll deploy a sample app to it from this GitHub repo. That's it. Let's create a zip file from it. And okay. And now deploy it to the web app. And that should be it. Let's go back to the Azure portal. Here we are. Let's look at the app services. Cool, there it is. Just like a normal app service. Let's see. It has almost all the features that other app services have. And I'll take a look at the URL. That's it. This is the sample application. Very cool. Azure Arc can use an Arc-enabled Kubernetes cluster as compute for services like app service web apps and functions. And in the next video, we'll connect a SQL server to Azure Arc. Go and check it out.